Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have another fish keeping video for you. If you're into fish keeping, that's what we're going to be talking about. We're going to be talking about what chemicals, what products and things I use in my aquarium. So if you want to see, just keep watching and we'll be back. I'm going to document my journey through my fish keeping, the highs, the lows, what I use, what I don't. Fish keeping along with me, we can help each other. If you're an established fish keeper, you've been doing it for years, 1, 15, 20, whatever, please put your input in on what I could be using, what I shouldn't use, what I should know, what's not important. Would be great help. As you all know, if you don't know, I have live bearers because, you know, I'm just, you know, starting out. So, but I do find that the Plotties are really my favorite. They're colorful, they're simple to take care of, and I'll get more into the whole live bearer stuff later. Research. I have gone into the store as well to talk to people, but they're the bigger chain pet stores like Petco and PetSmart and Pet Supermarket and stuff like that, because there's not in the area where I live, there aren't any like mom and pop kind of fish you know, aquatic stores or what, or pet stores that can really help you. There's no one really knowledgeable in my area, not that I can find. If you live in, that I have here is the Tetra Aqua Safe Plus. It makes tap water safe for fish. So this is the first product that I have. Please don't pay attention to my nails. I just said I broke it. So this is this one. On the front of it, it says monthly, I guess. Monthly maintenance. A lot of the products do say that. They do have the little emblems on the bottom that kind of tell you what you should be using it for. Say for instance, this other Tetra product I have, it also says, you know, in the corner it'll say weekly maintenance. And when I first started off in fish keeping, I was kind of like, well, what is that? I guess it's kind of like a guideline you should be using, just like when I'm going to show you these other products at the bottom. They also have a little guidelines on them. So, well, anyway, and it says it works in seconds. Enhanced formula for clearer water. Advanced formula for clearer water. Enhanced protective slime coat. Now, this is a water conditioner and dechlorinator, and it's for all fresh and marine aquariums. So marine, I'm assuming this saltwater aquariums. I have a freshwater tropical fish tank. I kind of keep it on, I have that heater in the back that's automatically set to 78 degrees. Sometimes I'll cut my air conditioning off and kind of let it heat up a little bit more. Sometimes, maybe like an 80, 82. And they seem to go pew, 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 pew. Like they're happier, I guess. I don't know. But this is, like I said, a water conditioner and dechlorinator. This is for using in your tap water. If you're new to the hobby, this is one of the things that, or I said I was gonna do them by brand, but I'm kind of getting into just might as well do. This is from API. This is Stress Coat Plus, just like this one's a plus as well. I think that both of these products, if I'm not mistaken, used to have a regular product that wasn't a plus. So I'm not really sure what the plus exactly, what it means, because if maybe there's something changed from this one to this one. I don't know if the previous packaging looked like this, but this one is a little different. So I'm probably, because it's water conditioner and dechlorinator, maybe that's what it is. But anyway, I have Stress Coat here from API, and it says it makes tap water safe, removes chlorine and chloramines, and detoxifies heavy metals. And it says protects fish. The healing power of aloe vera, proven to reduce fish stress and replace the slime coat. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the dechlorinator and the water conditioner. Excuse me. Okay, so In tap water, you need to have these chemicals, whatever brand you're using. Preferably, I think I prefer this one better over this one just from observing my fish. So I'm kind of into this one just a little bit more than this one. I started off using this one. This little bottle treats up to 200 gallons, so it's good. It keeps it for a while, and this one is 940 gallons or whatever. But you need a dechlorinator if you're using tap water, the water right out of your faucet, wherever you live. That water is supposed to be made for human consumption or human use. You're using it to cook with, wash your dishes with, wash your body with, wash your face with, you brush your teeth with it. Whatever you use your tap water for. I personally drink bottled water, but that's here nor there, a different discussion. But with the tap water, the things that are good for human consumption are not good for your fish. So you need something to either remove completely or neutralize those things in tap water that makes fish sick or kill them. That would be your chlorines. Your chloramines. I believe there's other things that have to do with like pH as well, where the balance of the pH could be off. It could be too high or too low. You could have like salts in your waters, and a lot of fish are sensitive to salts, especially if you're keeping freshwater tropical. A lot of those types of fish can be very sensitive to tap water and the things that are in them that are, like I said, are for human consumption and not for fish. So you need products in these lines to, like I said, neutralize or remove that so that your fish can live in it. Now, I guess the protective, correct me if I'm wrong, protective slime coat is just what it is. It's like a coat. A barrier, just like I would compare it to like a topical cream or lotion that you would use on your skin if you have dry skin. It keeps you, or like, you know, in the cold weather, you put like maybe petroleum jelly on your arm or your, like, cracked skin, so that you're not susceptible to infections that could lead to illness and disease. Well, I guess that's what a slime coat is for a fish. It helps the fish from being stressed out, and when fish get stressed out, they can get become sick, and they can be more susceptible to the diseases that are in, that could be in your tank from water quality, things like that, or coming from the fish store when you just buy them, or being around other fish that are in your tank when you add new ones and things like that. So having to protect, also the protective slime coat protects them from whatever ornaments and plants and things that you have in your tank that could be sharp. They can bump up against them. It protects their fins. It just makes them more calm and happy. I guess that's what the slime coat is for. So these are the products that you would need to condition the water, to keep them safe, to kind of keep them calm and happy and of that sort. So using these, which a product that I have is a weekly maintenance. These, I guess they say they're monthly, but I think that you use them each time you do a water change. I can go into water changes a little bit more later, which I will do. We're just kind of talking about products now. This is also something I use sometimes with water changes. If you are you've been in the hobby for a while, let me know if you use this or you don't, and you just rely on your water changes and you know, checking your water. But it's the Easy Balance Plus, maintains healthy water, it regulates ideal pH, reduces frequent water changes. And it says right on the bottle that it reduces nitrates. And then on the back, it was also talking about it regulates the pH and alkalinity at recommended levels, reduces nitrates and phosphates, which are, I guess, things in the water, waste products and stuff like that. And it says it adds vitamins, minerals, and electrolytes needed for vibrant, active fish. So I've been using this, and what it says is that I think the claims for some of these products are just kind of like, really? Like, this one says that you need to do a 50 to 75% water change in your aquarium at least once every 6 months using this product. So every week you put this in your tank. That's kind of what I'm getting the gist of it. Provides a safety net between water changes. It's, to me, it's kind of a confusing product, actually. It's like, okay, so when I need to do a water change, I pour this in there. Don't do a water change. Change a lot of my water. Do it and don't. Like, I don't know. But what I do is when I do a water change, I use a little bit of this. And they seem to be fairly okay with it right now. I don't know what they're doing. I think they're looking for food, but they're not gonna get it. And then down here I have, this is about halfway. It's a water clarifier, clears cloudy water, aquarium water, and it says safe in soft water conditions, quickly clears cloudy or hazy waters, safely settles, minute particles, phosphate free formula. It's a solutions. There are so many things that I've researched about cloudy water and what you could have, what problem you could have having cloudy water depending on the color of the haze and different things like that. I periodically sometimes have cloudy water, not often. If I do, it's usually because I'm doing a water change and I'm getting the gunk out, but sometimes it's me kind of getting rid of the bacteria, or I might have a bacterial bloom, whatever you may have. There are yeses and nos to water conditioners. Some people say the water conditioners work. Some people say they don't work. So yeah, there are two sides of the fence to water conditioners or water clarifiers. So if you have any thoughts on water clarifiers, let me know. I'm still debating if it works, honestly. That's all honesty for me right now. The next product I have is also from API, which is aquarium saw. Promotes fish health with improving gill function. A lot of people say, now it says that it's for, it says the top is all natural and it's for freshwater fish. I get a lot of, I've been watching a lot of videos and reading a lot of articles, and again, this is another product that's on the fence. Either you do it or you don't. You should, you shouldn't. A lot of people say that, I think they compare it to call it brackish water. I guess it's like really, really high salt content water, and I think that when I first got this product, I was kind of like, aquarium salt? Is that the same salt you use in, you know, for salt water and, you know, marine life? And I wasn't sure if it was the same type of salt, but I'm more than positive that it's not, because it says for freshwater fish. So I guess adding a little bit of this for whatever type of freshwater fish you have helps their gill function. I also hear that you can use it for treating some illnesses like ick and ripped fins, fin rot, stuff like that, you know, fin rot, mouth clout. There's like so many symptoms and things for diseases. Uses basically to promote you know, gill function, and like I said, for medicines, for treating, and you know, treating disease and infections and those sorts of things. And I was reading that with water changes, this necessarily doesn't disappear. It doesn't evaporate, that you have to take it out and add new water that doesn't have this in it. But I don't use it with every water change, I will say, because I'm still kind of on the fence of, is this product good for my Pilates? Is this good for for live bearers? That it's not good to you. Oh, and you don't, Pilates don't need this. They don't need this type of product. And then you have someone say, oh, they can benefit from a little salt. So after using it and having my fish, I'll say that I think that Pilates, that's the live bearers that I have, do benefit from a little bit of salt. I think it does help their gill function. They're less likely to be at the bottom for me, or all the way at the top. So I think it works. Let me know your thoughts on this product. This is a Petco Care branded product, and this is an ammonia remover for fresh water and salt water. It says it reduces the risk of a pH drop during uses and eliminates ammonia, chlorine, and chloramines. Now, I've heard of people, well, I've heard of you can overdose your tanks, and there's people who say, sometimes I overdose my tank and nothing happens, or I don't add enough stuff because I'm afraid of overdosing my tank. So those are issues there too. But I do use this like with my water conditioner product, but I use very little of it. And just sometimes if I have an ammonia spike, I'll try to use this. But I also have some Mellifix. This is from API. This is a fish illness treating product. It's guide, it just says for adding fish problem solving. Oops. I think at the bottom, this one said the same thing. It was just, it's not for adding fish, but I think it's for helping fish and with water changes or something. This says all natural, extracted from tea leaves. It rapidly repairs damaged fins, ulcers, and open wounds, promotes regrowth of damaged tissue and fins. And then on the back, it has what you can use it for. It's used to treat open red sores, fin and tail rot, open body wounds, eye cloud, pop eye, body slime, and mouth fungus. Those all sound very disgusting. And I pray that my fish don't get any of these problems. I did have one of my male fish, my Sunburst. He did have a ripped fin, and I wasn't sure where the ripped fin came from for him. He does tend to fight with the females, and the females do attack him sometimes. I figured it might have been from that. I also read up that it could have been from an ammonia spike. I did have an ammonia spike at that time. And then the fin just repaired itself on its own. I didn't even use anything, and it just kind of repaired. All I did was add a little bit of salt to the water and kind of let the water do room temperature so that I have these two products here. I have Stresszyme Plus, and I have Quick Start, which apparently is a new product. I was using the Tetra, what is it called? Is it called Quick Start? I don't think it's called Quick Start. It's called Start something. I don't know. I forgot what it's called, but it was also a bacterial product. This was the first one I have. I'm a little low on this one. And then I bought this one. This one was $15.99. I didn't realize how much this was until I left the store. Andrea, beneficial bacteria, I believe they're called nitrorhizome. I don't even know if the name is on here. That was from my research. Nitrorhizome, something like that. Something like that. If you know what it's called for those two types of bacteria, the one that gets rid of the I can't get that word right. It gets rid of the ammonia and the nitrites, and then converts them to nitrate, which is not harmful for fish, but could be harmful in higher quantities of over 40 parts per million. So you know what those bacteria are called. Leave them in the comments, because I forgot what it's called. Well, anyway, so bacteria, it starts the nitrogen cycle. And the nitrogen cycle is starting off with the ammonia that comes from excess waste in the tank. Excess waste could be extra uneaten food in your tank from overfeeding every day, or however often you feed your fish. It could come from decaying plants, plant matter, if you have natural plants in your aquarium. It also can come from the fish waste as well, and it creates ammonia after a certain amount of time. And then it goes from, which is toxic to your fish in any quantity, higher or low. If it's anything from 0.25 parts per million and higher, it could be very, very toxic. And then you go into the nitrate. I'm gonna say nitrate, and I'm trying not to say nitrate. The nitrites is also toxic to your fish, and it gets converted from the ammonia to that, and then from that to the nitrates. Now that's where the bacteria comes in. You add bacteria to your tank. That's where you're trying to cycle your tank. You could do a fish cycle, or you could get a little risky and you could do a fish in cycle. I did a fishless cycle. It improves the biofilter as beneficial bacteria for a healthy aquarium, all natural. And you know, Enobacillus contains millions of live bacteria to destroy sludge in the gravel bed, whatever, whatever substrate you use. Keeps the glass and plants clean. Also helps boost the natural aquarium cycle. So I use this first. I just use, you know, put it in there, do the water changes, and kind of boost my I also put it in my biofilter, in my filter right there. I put it in the biofilter to kind of help keep the water clean, and it breaks down the ammonia, and I feel like it's not breaking down the ammonia enough because maybe it's not growing fast enough. So I continue to keep adding it. Basically, you just do what's suggested, and then now the bacteria is not going to grow in the water. Doesn't grow in the water. You just put it in there. You can also put it in your filter, which I do. It's not gonna. It doesn't grow on the filter. Oh, grow on the filter. It doesn't grow on the. It doesn't grow in the water. It's just not suspended in the water. They're not like, let's eat this ammonia. Let's eat this nitrate. No, it grows on the things in your aquarium, your substrates, your plants, your ornaments, the glass. All inside of your filter media, your biofilter inside of there, your carbon filter inside the intake tubes, whatever type of filter system you use, that's where the bulk of your bacteria is going to grow. So it's not suspended in the water like I kind of thought in the beginning, and like a lot of people do think that it's just kind of hanging out in the water, and it's not. It's not hanging out in the water. So I pretty much think these two products are pretty much the freaking same thing. I'm not really sure. This is regular care weekly. This one says startup and water change, adding fish. I'm not really sure exactly what the difference is between these two products. But if you know the answer to that, please let me know, because I'm basically thinking it's the same exact thing, just with different wording on the bottle. I'm not really sure, so if you do know the difference between these two products, please do let me know.